So have you ever woken up and felt the morning rush and say, I have so much to accomplish today. What do I do? Where do I start? Where do I begin? Who do I call? Who do I contact? What do I need to nail today to make sure I have a very, very productive day? That was me, and I was all over the place before I figured out this method of how to arrange your day so therefore you can become a first generation cash flow millionaire. So I'm going to discuss and share with you and unpack our morning routine so therefore you can see a little bit about what we do and maybe you can adopt some of these things in this episode of the 7-Figure Squad happening in 3, 2, 1. Let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jeter. Steady through the rigor, yeah, I'm getting bigger.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula here, hailing to you from Dallas, Texas. And yes, it is December 1st. So what we're doing today, and you know we did this last year, we're launching Vlogmas Year 2. What is Vlogmas? In the YouTube community, there's a episode every day for those vloggers, those YouTubers that want to provide value to their community. We're doing Vlogmas, which means an episode every day for the next 24 days, all the way up until Christmas, to make sure you get to know who we are, what we do, and more importantly, what's in it for you to follow our channel. So today is day one of Vlogmas, so please expect every day an episode of value to help you have a much better life. So therefore, 2022 is the beginning of the greatest years of your financial life. And if you are about that life, put it in the comment section below. I am beginning a millionaire life. I am beginning a millionaire life in the comment section below. But before I get started, I want to remind you again, our goal is to get to 150,000 subs. So therefore we can award a church, charity, or nonprofit $5,000 on behalf of the squad. That's right, you and I, on behalf of the 7-Figure Squad, to help them help other people. So please hit subscribe so therefore we can get closer to awarding that church, charity, or nonprofit $5,000 on behalf of you. All right, so let's get into it. How do we have a millionaire morning routine? Let me give you a little bit of insight. It starts with step number one. We don't wake up and just say, okay, what are we gonna get done today? What's gonna happen today? That's rule number one. We don't get started the morning of. Millionaires, at least my wife and I, we start the night before. So if you ask anybody in an organization, we do national conference calls to unify the heartbeat, the mindset, the expectations, and the focus of our national organization. And by the way, if you didn't know this already, my day job is we run a national insurance agency. And so what we do on Sunday nights to incorporate this habit with our organization, within our staff, within our independent contractors all over the country, we plan the Monday morning, the night before, our next moves, what worked, what didn't work, what got done, who I need to call, what projects need to get done. And by the way, this is all done after we put the kids to bed. But once they're in bed, once they're put to bed, once they're asleep, then I put these lists together. I go outside my patio, I light up a cigar, I go over my list, I go over my next moves, I go over the game plan I just gave you here a few moments ago, and how we're going to attack tomorrow. And when it's all said and if I'm satisfied with that list, the people I need to contact tomorrow, the projects I need to get done, my social media content that we get done for the next day, the things I need to go over with my team the next day, with our staff, operations, the associates I need to contact, then I open up a cigar, light up a cigar, and I watch a documentary. I watch something, a movie, something on YouTube that gets me charged up. That is my routine. It might be midnight, it might be 1 o'clock, might be 2 o'clock, but eventually I'll hit the rack, I'll go to bed, get some shut eye. Now here's the thing too as well, before we do all this, I make sure that my last appointment of the day, after kids are put to sleep, after I light up the cigar, maybe during the cigar, is my last appointment of the day, as I'm going through all these different things too as well, is a last meeting with my wife. My wife and I are in business together, we're running a family together, we're raising children together, we're discussing everything. My last appointment of the day, yes, it's my wife. We make sure we button up any arguments, we button up anything that may have been left outstanding throughout that day. I can't say it is perfect all the time, but you know, we have our good moments, we have our bad moments, but we make sure we go through the moments that nothing divides us apart because we're building a life together and we want to minimize those unnecessary arguments. And what do we fall asleep to? To help me go to sleep, we listen to music called whole tones. It's something I discovered about a year ago, 2 years ago, when I spoke for the Man of War conference, and I got introduced to this doctor. He's a Christian entrepreneur, and he's got this little device that plays music that brings the megahertz, the way you listen to music, your whole body, because everybody's body has certain rhythms, and this whole tones has frequencies that get your body into a deep sleep state, I think it's called REM or something like that. So it gets you to REM faster, because it's one thing to sleep, but it's another thing to get rest. So even though, and I'm going to share with you, I don't get a lot of sleep at night. You know, some people say, well, how much sleep do you get? 7-8 hours now, bro? I like get like 4 or 5 hours at most, and I'm jacked up. I'm ready to go for the next day, because it's not the sleep time I'm focused on. It's the rest time I'm focused on. And this whole tones type, understanding these frequencies of the music and the affirmations that are layered behind this music, gets me into a deeper sleep state faster. So my body's going to start healing. I can wake up rejuvenated and I can attack the next day. Okay, so we get this 4, 5, maybe 6 hours of sleep at night. I wake up, first things we do, we don't check phones. We don't check DMs. We don't check messages. We check in with God. We pray, we meditate, we have that alone time. My favorite part of that day was that everything is quiet. I see the sun coming up, it's still dark outside. I see the sunrise starting to peek up over the homes and the horizon and the tree lines. That's my favorite part of the day. That's a way for me to say to the sun, I beat you up, son. But at the same time, too, simultaneously, I'm like, good morning, God. Good morning, Lord. Goodness gracious. What an amazing time of the day. And that's the first fruits. We talk about tithes and offerings in our finances. Well, the first tithes and offerings also of the day that God has given you, that God has made. So therefore, you can rejoice and be glad in it, right? And so therefore, prayer, meditations, affirmations is the first thing that goes on in our household before we check up on any of our phones. And then when we do get up, we wake up the kids, we raise them up in a positive energy. How many guys are used to a morning routine and everybody just jumps out of bed and everything's crazy? Rah! Kids, let's go. Get dressed. Brush your teeth. Eat some breakfast. Grab your bags. We're late. We're late. We're late. And that's why we chose to become entrepreneurs. That's why we chose to go opposite of what a lot of people experience in their morning routine, which is a massive amounts of stress. Now, the flip side to this is we put ourselves pressure, we put ourselves under pressure. There's a difference between dealing with stress and asking for pressure. See, millionaires ask for pressure. Do they have stress because they have people to answer to and people to hold the call? Of course they do, but they ask for it. What type of life did you sign up for? Did you sign up a life of average and ordinary, six-figure income? Or are you watching this challenge because you want to become a first-generation cash flow, faith-based millionaire? So we want to make sure that our children, we set the example for our children to make sure they wake up, we're having a good time, we're having fun, we're chasing around. We actually have a playlist. There's some songs that we're listening to. We make sure we have breakfast with the kids. I mean, what's our breakfast? We have yogurt. Of course, for Filipinos, we have eggs and rice. Sometimes we have oatmeal. Bottom line, either those three wraps up with a protein shake. Part of this also, morning routine has to involve diet and exercise. Has to involve diet and exercise. Some part of your day has to incorporate some form of exercise. I'm not talking about a full-blown, you know, workout routine. Some form of it has to have some physical routine so therefore you can start engaging the body. Now, if you don't get to work out in the morning, we make sure that sometime during the day we have some form of exercise, whether it be at lunchtime or in the evening, but we're going to get our exercise that day because money is energy. And energy is money. And so we want to make sure we are operating the highest forms of energy possible, because if we're dragged to be around, nobody wants to be around us. Well, guess what? The morale goes down in a company, the morale goes down in our organization, the morale goes down nationwide. And we want to make sure we set the right example energy-wise and attitude-wise when we first get into the office. One of the things that my trainers asked me to do is, Matt, hydrate, hydrate, hydrate. I noticed that when I'm not hydrating enough, I notice at least my brain gets foggy. My thinking is not clear. I start slurring my words. And so hydrate, hydrate, hydrate your body. And listen, I'm not a physical trainer. My trainer, Milton, his job is to make sure I'm always pushing my limits, that I'm operating the best physical optimal rate possible. So he's always coaching me. He's always contacting me. Hey, did you drink? Did you drink? Are you ready to work out tonight? Are you ready to work out this afternoon? So he's ready and available to make sure, but he's making sure also that I'm drinking and I'm ready for that workout. Because my trainer, I told him, listen, I don't care to look a certain way. I don't care to hit a certain amount of weight. I don't care to smash these weights like I may have wanted to in my 20s and 30s. Your job, Milton, your job is to make sure you push my limits. Because as a millionaire, I want to get to the next level of my life. I think when I started thinking like this, I was making $50,000 a year, $80,000, $100,000 a year. My job is always to push my limbs. How can I crack open this potential? How can I make sure that whatever plateau I'm at, I realize, man, I'm at the top of this level, but I'm also at the bottom of the next level. Great, I get to the top of the next level. Okay, I'm at the top of that next level, but I'm also at the bottom of the next level. So my trainer's job to make sure I'm hydrated, I'm fed, I'm exercised, I'm ready for the next level physically, mentally. My job is to make sure my spirit is right, my head is right, my emotions are right, so therefore I can attack this thing. Because oftentimes people think that making $1 million is just about sales, just about transactions, about margins or distribution. Sure, that's part of it. That's a function of what you need to get done, but how you get it done and how you feel about your day, how you feel about your month, how you feel about your quarter, your year, has to be how you deal with your physical body. And then when all this is done, now I'm having 15, 20, 30 minutes of, I'm on Zoom, in phone calls, in person. Monday mornings is one of my favorite mornings because my team and I, if I'm in town, we get to grab breakfast and we get to sample some of the best menu selections of that particular restaurant. And I like making friends with the servers, I like making friends with the restaurant owners because I want to go back. I want them to remember me because I want them to know that there's good people in the community that are entrepreneurs, that are millionaires, that all millionaires aren't jerks. And there's actually millionaires out there that's actually helping people. And after that, then my first phone calls are my new agents, new associates to our firm, new staff to our firm. I want to make sure they get to know who I am, that I'm a real living, breathing person, that I'm just not a title. I'm just not somebody you see on Zoom once a week, that actually want to know their goals and their dreams. And the second type of people I'm calling in that morning routine are associates, brand new associates, associates hitting goals, reaching goals, getting towards their next personal threshold and breaking through new barriers. These are the guys I want to push, especially towards the middle of the month, towards the end of the month, where sometimes you go through ebbs and flows of a month. And so I want to make sure I'm there to help remind people of their goals, because don't get too much caught up in your work and reminding people with my phone call why they're doing it to begin with. And then I wrap up my morning looking forward to a power lunch. In other words, I never eat lunch by myself. And who am I having a power lunch with? I mean, with somebody that's not a client of our firm and somebody that's not an associate of our firm. And I also want to bring on with me in that power lunch an associate of my firm, so therefore I can teach this new associate how to build relationships in the community. And we talk about being a mayor of the city, getting to know people in a short period of time and getting to know who you are, what you do potentially, what this relationship can mean in their life. So we're also out there during these power lunches to sow new relationships, to cultivate new relationships, to send business, to cultivate new business. And by the way, I'm in the position also is making sure I'm giving them business. So before I ask for business, I'm in the business of doing business with them first. And so that's just the way I go about business. And for the last, going on 22 years now, it's worked out fairly well. So that being said, guys, I wanna know what your thoughts are on this morning routine. Is this something you incorporate? If so, put it in the comment section below. I am incorporating a millionaire morning routine. I am incorporating a millionaire morning routine. Well, all right, guys, there you have it. Episode 1 of Vlogmas. And if you want to see a specific topic, maybe you have a suggestion for Scripture Sundays of a Bible study that you want me to unpack, or whatever subject you want in terms of wealth building, wealth creation, so therefore you can think like a millionaire, you can strategize, so therefore one day soon you'll become a first generation cash flow millionaire. So before I let you go, please check out this video here, 7 Habits of Highly Effective Millionaires. There was a live training I did. I think that will bring a lot of value for you, especially if you're looking for 2022 becoming the best and greatest years of your financial life. And watch this other video right here, which is one hack that millionaires use every day. And make sure before I let you go, if this was of any value for you, please share it with somebody that you can think of have a better morning routine. That being said, guys, if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click like, subscribe, and hit notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. There you have it. Vlogmas 2021 is about to begin. Thanks for tuning in. From Dallas, Texas, I'm your Money Smart Guy. And until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today. We'll be right back.